Today I want to show you what you can do with simple utility knife in shoemaking, but with the combination with this super sharp Japanese blade. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel and click the bell button to be notified when my new video will come out. So let's start. Learn how to make shoes with my step-by-step video courses. There are a few basic shoemaking knives that you should use on shoemaking and should learn how to work with them. But if you are a beginner in shoemaking, you can start making your shoes working with simple utility knife. But what is important here is to work with good blade. And as I mentioned in the beginning, a good blade that I use in my work and recommend to all my students and to you is blade BD-100. It's very sharp blade, and you can compare it with a simple blade that you can, that comes usually with a simple utility knife. You can see right now that there are many differences here between these two blades. This blade, the Japanese blade, has sharp angle, is 45 degrees, and it also very sharp. The blade itself is very sharp, and this angle is very comfortable to work with when you work in shoemaking, and in a few minutes I will talk about it. What is important here is to keep this blade sharp, and I made a video how to sharpen this blade, and you can check the link to this tutorial in the description below the video. And after you see that the blade is not already sharp anymore, you can change it like this, and you will have sharper blade again. There are three ways to use utility knife in shoemaking. Let's start with number one. In pattern making, when you apply the design of your shoes on the masking tape, you will need to cut it out and attach it to the cardboard. So working with this utility knife and use this Japanese blade, you will do it professionally. So, for example, I will need to cut this part. I follow the design that I created here. Then we need to take it out from the shoe last. And attach it to the cardboard. Now we continue with the same blade, with the same knife, with the same blade to cut this cardboard pattern. So we cut out following the lines. Just now I only demonstrate how to work with. But in pattern making, we need to add different seam allowance. And you will see that it was very easy to cut cardboard working with this knife. So this is number one in pattern making. Cut out all masking tape pieces from shoe last and attach it to the cardboard. And then cut out all your patterns from cardboard. Number two, clicking or cutting leather pieces. There are special clicking knife to cut upper end lining, but you don't need to have this special knife because utility knife will do same work excellent. So we cut different types of leather with different thickness of leather working with same utility knife and same Japanese blade. So when you cut, you just need to put your pattern and cut it out. You see, it's very easy to do it when you know how to work with. Okay, I will not show the entire process of cutting. Some of you maybe think that it's a good idea to cut your upper end lining with scissors, but believe me, working with scissors, you will have a big room for mistakes because you will do it not accurately. When you will transfer all patterns with silver pen and then you will cut with scissors, you will leave probably too much distance between the actual mark and the line that you will cut. So work with simple utility knife. It will do this kind of work professionally, okay? So you can cut all types of leather, upper lining, and even sole bands. You see this, what I cut working with this blade. What is important here is to have a sharp blade and a wet a little bit this thick leather. And then you will do it in few steps because it's very thick. But it's do this work excellent. And you will have clean cut. And that's why I recommend to cut all your upper parts, lining parts, and even sole bands working with this utility knife and Japanese blade. Number three, skiving. It's one of the most important processes in shoemaking, where you need to skive upper and lining to create beautiful and comfortable shoes. So there is special shoemaking knife to do this work. And I recommend to work with this shoemaking knife that has curved blade. And I already made a tutorial how to work with this blade. It comes together with my shoemaking tools kit with 1 year shoemaking program. But if you can't find this knife or can't work with this knife at the beginning, what you can do is to work with simple utility knife with Japanese blade. Working with simple blade, you will do horrible job, so don't use it to skive your uppers and lining, your upper and lining. But what is important here is to have, of course, sharp blade. So how to skive working with utility knife and this blade? You will do same things that I already explained working with this blade, with this knife, but I will show you how to work with utility knife. You need to hold your upper in the beginning. We need to skive one edge, and then we need to hold here. You see, same operation. And then we will skive needed piece of leather where we need to have a thin edge. You see, it's very easy to work with the utility knife because it has this Japanese blade that is very sharp. Okay, so you see, it skived the edge in the same way if I will skive with the professional shoemaking knife. Okay, in the beginning you can use utility knife, but remember that this blade is much better, and this blade you will use in many other steps of shoemaking. Okay, conclusion: working with this simple utility knife, this one or this one, the design and color doesn't important. What is important is to have this excellent Japanese blade BD-100. You can start making your shoes and use it in these three ways that I just showed you in this tutorial. If you have questions, please comment below the video and I will answer all your questions. Don't forget to subscribe to this channel and click the bell button to be notified when my new video will come out. Thank you for watching and see you in the next video. Bye.